Seijin here. If you never heard of one of the hottest AI platforms called Pika Labs, no, not that Pika. This Pika.
Pika Pika.
I'm going to show you how you can generate your own text-to-video or image-to-video without paying a dime. Plus, I'm going to show you how to use the newest option, Encrypt, and as an added bonus, a super-secret tip that only you should know. So watch until the very end. So if you like this sort of content, please make sure to like the video and subscribe to this channel. Let's dive right in. To start, you need the Discord app. Go to discord.com and download the app, or you can open up the Discord in your browser. Once you have Discord, go to Pika Labs at pika.art and sign up by clicking on Join the Beta button. This may change in the future, but at the moment, all video generation is free and unlimited, and you can use it commercially. All links to the video are in the description for your reference. Now with Pika Labs added to Discord, you see a long menu on the left. You'll see the welcome channels for newcomers, a place to chat, discuss prompts, and ask for support. You have your community channels where they have daily competitions and sometimes even with large cash prizes, so make sure you participate. Under Creations, you have your Generate channels where you can generate your videos. Now let's get to the fun stuff. Let me click on one of the Generate channels so we can start generating. In the prompt box, if you type slash, you'll see commands like animate, create, encrypt image, encrypt text. All videos generated on Pika are 3 seconds in length, but watch until the very end and I'll show you how you can extend the length of the video. Now, in order to prompt the text to image, type in slash and click create. For my first prompt, I used an astronaut exploring a beautiful alien planet, sleek futuristic suit, and hit enter. You can practice prompting your own videos as much as you want. Go bonkers because there's no limit. And voila! To download, you can click on the download button on the top right corner of the video. Now let's do an image to video prompt. Type slash and click on animate. You can drag and drop the image you want to animate in the image box and hit enter to start generating. Or you can click on the plus more option and click prompt to add an additional text prompt with the parameter. I'll drop an image of a BMW and add a text prompt, car driving quickly and changing colors with a motion forward parameter. And here's the video. Not too bad, huh? Let's look at all the different parameters you can use on Pika. In the future, they'll definitely add more and I plan on updating you every time, so make sure you subscribe to this channel. First up, you have your camera parameter with zoom in or zoom out parameters. You can add the zoom in or zoom out at the end of your prompt to control the zoom effect. Here is your camera parameter with pan up, down, left, or right. You can also pan two parameters at the same time as long as it's two non-conflicting directions. You can also use a rotate parameters clockwise, counterclockwise, and anti-clockwise, which is the same as counterclockwise. You can even adjust the FPS or frames per second. Currently, 24 FPS is the max, but they may go up in the future. Here are three videos with different FPS values. The videos seem much smoother at higher FPS. Default is 24. The motion parameter controls the strength of the motion in the video. The higher the value, the stronger the motion. The motion value starts at 0 and goes up to 4. The default is a 1. The guidance scale controls how closely the video is related to the text. So higher the value, the closer it will be to the actual inputted text prompt. 0 being the lowest and 24 is the highest, where 12 is the default value. Notice the difference? And then you have your negative prompts, where you input things you don't want the video to have. You have your aspect ratio if you want to change the width height of a video. And then you have seed where you can generate videos more consistently by using the video seed number found at the end of its file when you download it. Encrypt text and encrypt image options are the two latest updates by Pika Labs. To simply explain, you can input a text or image for Pika to use as a mask when generating the videos. Let me show you. Type slash and click encrypt text. Type in the message box the text that you want to use as a mask. I'll use Seijin as the mask. Then in the prompt box, type in the image you want to generate into a video. I'll prompt it with incredible blue waves, beautiful beach. You can choose a font by clicking plus more option and click font to choose a font. Currently, there's 5 fonts you can choose from. Before this one, I'll choose the comic font and hit enter. Voila! You can see the text Seijin masked into the wave ocean. You can control the visibility of the text by using the wave parameter and enter a value between 0 and 2. The default is set at 1. You can also set the text size by using the size parameter and select value from 50 to 100. The default is 100. Here's what a text size of 50 and 100 looks like. Now for the encrypt image option. Select the encrypt image option and drag and drop an image with a pattern you want Pika to use as a mask. Pika won't care if your image is black and white or colored. But for this to work best, you want to use a two-color image, just pure black and pure white. I'm going to use this image as the mask. I used to prompt a massive library of books. You can see how the swirls were masked over the library to give you a cool looking pattern hidden in your image. Here's another sample I did using this pattern with the prompt Cloudy Blue Skies. With the encrypt image, you can also use the weight parameter here as well. Now if you made it this far, it's time for me to reveal to you the super secret tip that will make generating videos on Pika a lot more interesting. Open up a browser and go to finalframe.net. You can extend the length of your video beyond the 3-second limit to any length you want. This site basically takes a snapshot of the last frame in your video so you can save it as an image, upload it back to Pika, and have it animate the next 3 seconds. You can repeat the process over and over until you get the desired length in your video. Let me quickly demonstrate. Let me add the video of the encrypted text I created earlier. Click on the final frame, click download this frame, and save it. Go back to Pika Discord and choose the animate option. Drag and drop the final frame image and hit enter. Voila, here's the next 3 seconds of my wave video. Repeat this step as many times as you want. Now that you have multiple videos generated using Final Frame, you need to put it all together. I highly recommend using CapCut, which is a free image and video editing software. I'll leave the link in the description. Open CapCut and click on the import button to import all the videos you've generated. Drag and drop each video in order into the video frame slot below. Once you have all the videos in place, you can click on the export button. Name the video in the title box, click video exporting, and click export. Here is your final product.